time to film.
You on your hands and knees. Time to film.
Hi.
This is on.
Yeah. Is this thing on?
The seaweed ew.
He likes to eat seaweed. Do other people comment down below if you like to eat seaweed? I know Ariana Grande does, but you know, she's skinny, so we'll let her be. Anyways, I'm here with Jordan today.
Hello.
Baby Jordan.
The girl coon.
But yeah, this is my best friend. We met online, kind of. When we were like, what?
Low Anthony.
So like, we both had an Ariana Grande fan page on Instagram. He was Fave Grande, I was Peppermint Butera. Oh. And we were in a trio called the Fatties, if you remember us, with Bibble Me Grande. And so me, Jordan, and Gia took on the world for a little while, basically. But then now it's just me and Jordan most of the time, but I'm okay with that. And then like we met in person how long later? Because Lohan thing didn't really count.
We met like the next year in like June.
Was it like,
it was the summer.
It like a year?
It was June 25th.
Yeah, so we met like a year later, and then since then he's been coming to Rhode Island to visit me like, like 6 times a year?
More.
Pretty often, yeah. He comes and sees me all the time, which is so fun because I love him. He's my only friend.
Oh,
here you go. So I posted on TikTok to ask us questions, and we're gonna get to the questions. Fun, right? Hey guys. It's my smoker voice for me. I'm drinking straight pink Whitney right now. Biggest lie you've told each other?
Oh, I can. I love you.
Biggest lie. Biggest. I mean, I can think of one, but not really something I want to see on camera.
Let me keep thinking.
Yeah. Well, when I used to be an asshole, like Jordan would like come, but he would kind of be like, "Are you gonna like pull this shit again?" Because I used to have him come here, but then I would just have my friends come over every night and like get drunk with me. But he doesn't like that.
Oh,
so like he would end up just like hiding in my room. So like basically before he would come, I would be like, "No, like my friends aren't gonna come over every night. Like I promise." And then they would. That's like the biggest. That wasn't even like a lie. It's just, yeah, it's kind of a lie.
Wait, I still didn't think of one.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hi, Tara.
What's one thing you've always been embarrassed to tell each other? Embarrassed to tell each other.
I feel like
that without you, I would be literally nothing.
Not nothing,
but like if he wasn't, if he just like upped and left me one day and like turned his back on me, I don't know what the fuck I would do.
Wait, you're answering all the questions that I like don't know how to answer.
No, there's so many like that.
I'm not really embarrassed to tell her anything.
Yeah.
Very open relationship.
We've been friends for a very long time.
Let me not say relationship.
What's one thing you hate about the other person?
Yeah, I don't like
this question.
I have a couple.
Tara!
Not that I hate about you. It's not things that I hate about him. It depends on the day.
She hates that my pussy's Versace. She's not sympathetic or empathetic at all.
Yeah.
And she only thinks about her feelings.
I'm sympathetic sometimes. It's just like, it depends on like the person.
Very much Gemini, very much Cancer, which is another question.
Yeah. What's something I hate about?
I have like a couple.
No, it's not something else getting into a fight after this because I'm like, anyways, next question.
Let me drive home.
Have you guys ever hooked up?
Never.
You sure? What about that one time? Should we tell them? Why does everyone want to know if we've hooked up or not? That is 80% of the fucking questions.
I'm getting very much
problems. I clearly said that he was gay. Also, there's one question that's like, have you guys ever like thought about being more than friends? And like,
I'm playing the long game.
Everyone thinks he's playing the long game, but it's been how many years?
5.5.
I don't really remember when this was. I think it was like right in the first year. It was before I met you. I liked him for like a week, but I don't really know why. I remember calling Gia. I called Gia and I was like, girl, what do I do? And I remember laying on my bed at Cinnamon Drive, like, what do I do? Because I had a crush
on him. Cinnamon Drive!
I had a crush on him for like a week, but I like knew he was gay. I knew like, I just thought that I could like, you know, but the first time he slept over, my mom made him sleep on like this dog bed in the corner of my room.
And then I got up one morning and I was just like sitting in Tara's bed just like talking to her just because it was like the morning and we wanted to talk to each other, closer to each other. And then she comes in and she's just like, why are you in Tara's bed, Jordan? And I was like
mommy's gay! Like, have you guys ever done it? Have I ever fucked anyone even next to you? I don't think so.
Let's not answer that on this.
Have I?
Channel. Yes. Keith and...
Oh, yeah! So Jordan was here for like a week, like probably in the beginning of this year. I was in between two guys at the time. So I fucked both of these guys in the same week. Actually, I think it was in the same 24 hours.
I gotta go. I gotta get the fuck out of this night video.
No, he did. He sat in my bedroom and listened to us.
No, I put headphones on and I called my Uber. That's the pounding on the wall for me. Yeah. It was like, the couch for me. Favorite memory together. I'm gonna do that one.
Favorite memory together. Oh, wow, there's so
many. Driving to Washington, D.C. to see Ariana in a broken down BMW.
We drove to Washington, D.C. in a BMW that had no fucking AC.
No AC.
And no music.
No aux. And there was a buzzer going off the entire 10 hours or however long it was.
I think it was a 9-hour drive there and a 9-hour drive back. Or
we're,
like,
we're going to the Boston show the next day. Yeah.
We always try to manifest shit like the day before and it just never happens. All the windows were down the entire way.
Yep.
Because it was so hot.
No, and the sunroof.
And the sunroof. And the sunroof.
And then you poured the Fiji water on you.
I was pouring water bottles on me while we were driving because it was so hot. It was like 95 degrees in the car. And then I got broken up with.
Right before the meet and greet.
When we were
It was like 5 a.m. I like wake up. She's like, Ned.
Ned.
Like,
Ned.
I don't know. He like saw my text messages. Like, me.
And we stayed at my family's house. Which, oh my god, the fucking.
Smoking bongs in the car, hotboxing, walking in. Crashing the car right in front of KFC on the way to get tacos.
We were on our way back from the meet and greet and I crashed my car into someone. Pissed. I was like,
why is he acting like this? What? I just hit his car and there's a dent in the back.
If you could change one thing about each other, what would it be?
These questions.
I don't think I would. I wouldn't.
Whatever I just said. Just that empathetic. You, well, I'm going to change my mind because he did.
There's nothing I would change about you. Craziest memory that y'all share? Craziest? Do you want to tell the carnival story on the YouTube channel?
So we went to, wait, where was it?
It was like a stupid little carnival in Warwick.
We went to a carnival in Warwick and we literally just went there just to look around and then we went on the Ferris wheel and then we were leaving. And as we were leaving, this guy like screams at me. And Tara, I was just like, got really, really triggered by it more than I did because I was just like, oh, another day. And she's like, she like runs after the car. I'm just like, it's okay. I'm like, fine. She's like, no, it's not okay. She's like chasing after them. I'm like,
there was so many people. Have you ever liked each other for a week? I liked him.
I just love him.
Funniest memory high. Like, I just don't remember.
Me climbing up her balcony. She lives on the third floor.
Third floor.
And I climbed up the balcony high because we put our phones inside. And we're like, let's just go, like, experience things and, like,
without
live
our
off our phones.
Like, disconnected.
We're like, let's just
We were walking to Speedway.
We went to the gas station just to get, like, a lighter, I think. Or it was, like, backwards or something.
Yeah, and we left the keys. And then, so he had to like climb up like 3 stories of balconies. What's your favorite thing about each other?
I love that she can bring the same energy into any room and she doesn't like dilute it.
My favorite thing about Jordan, I don't know, it's like everything. Let me like think.
It's the gap for me.
My favorite thing about Jordan is that we have gotten into so many like not like fights, but like bickers. I just used to be like a bitch basically, and he has stuck through me through every single bad phase where other people haven't. So like I've went through a bunch of like pretty bad phases in my life. He told me that like I was doing things that were wrong or like this and that, like he guided me, but he never left me. You know what I'm
saying? This fucking channel, I'm like, wait, where am I?
Did you guys ever have fights that almost made you stop being friends?
Can we not do that question? Oh, so you're in Rhode Island and you're not coming to visit me, but you're driving through Rhode Island like you're going to New York?
Oh, wait, that.
Not the same.
What would you guys do if you could switch places for one day?
I would definitely fuck a guy because I want to know what it feels like. I like always wanted to know what it feels like to have a vagina. I'm like,
oh, I've always wanted to know what it feels like to have a dick. But like,
I'm a bottom.
What would I do with you? I'd hang out.
It's the hair for me.
I would hang out with your friends because I feel like
they're
really
fucking
fun.
Funny.
Well, they're really. I feel like they're fun to smoke with.
Yeah.
They look fun.
I love them.
Is it hard not living close to your best friend?
Of course it is.
It's hard because like I want to be
but,
with him all the time.
The connection's never different. Like we could like, literally not hang out for a year and we come back and just like
and
come
just,
back to the same thing.
Yes. Like, that's exactly what I was gonna say. Like there's never like
I feel
a.
Like everybody always says that, but it's so true.
It's
bond.
True.
It's insane. I'm
no,
like,
yeah, it's true. And like it makes it more special when he is here. You know.
Can you go live, please? She's banned. Oop. Favorite Ariana Grande song?
Touch It and Thinking About You.
I don't know, Menace.
Thinking About You. Wait, I need to find my jewel.
Probably Needy. First impression of each other.
He's fat.
First impression. So the first time I saw like a picture of him or like knew who he was from the Lohanthony meet and greet that we like.
Don't insert picture here.
No, yeah, we were both at it, but we didn't really know each other that well, so we didn't like talk or anything. But like, I just remember seeing you, and I remember seeing the same meet and greet picture online.
My first impression was, I was like, oh my god, she's friends with Lohanthony, because she used to pretend like she was friends with celebrities because she like bought meet and greets, and then she was like, just hung out with like Lohanthony this weekend. Missed you, baby. Us.
We already answered. It's an embarrassing moment together. Oh my god, I have an embarrassing moment of us. So like, there was this kid that was on the show The Fosters.
Oh my god!
His name is Gavin McIntosh. He was in Rhode Island while we were hanging out. We watched this show together, so we were like, oh my god, this kid is in Rhode Island. So I Instagram DM'd him, and I was like, hey, do you want to like meet up? Like, we were like big fans, like we want to meet you. So he was like, sure, like, I want to, like, we can meet up, like, to take pictures and whatnot. So we met him at this movie theater, me and him together, and we took pictures, and then we had, like, the thought in our head that, like, he wanted to, like, see the movie with us or something.
It was so embarrassing.
I don't know why we thought that. So Jordan said something to him. I forget what you said.
He was
with his grandparents. This kid was with his grandparents, and Jordan said,
you want to go sit down now or something?
Yeah, you want to go like sit down now? Like in the movie, because we thought we were going to watch the movie with him, and he was like, oh, well, I'm with my grandparents, so like, I'll see you guys later.
But he did not say it like that. He was like, I'm with my grandparents.
Yeah.
He was
like, would y'all ever live together if you could?
We're living together.
Yes, we're planning on it, actually. You're the only person I feel motivated to do things around. Because I don't have any other friends, but like every time I have had other friends, like they just make me feel like a blob. I don't know how to like
that trash bag on our porch.
Explain it. They make me feel like a trash bag on my porch. Mm. What places have you traveled together?
Miami went to Rolling Loud last year. Washington for Ariana.
LA soon. And then we tried to go to LA, but it didn't work.
We bought plane tickets to LA and bought pit tickets for Ariana and just never went.
And just never
didn't
went. Get a
refund. First kiss story. We didn't kiss.
How long have you guys been friends for?
5.5 years. I don't even remember the day. It was literally November 15th.
I miss your What I Eat in a Day videos. I post them every day. Every day. And when I get comments like this, it makes me not want to fucking post them because you guys aren't grateful. I post them every day for 3 months now. And I eat the same things every single day, so I don't know.
Me scrolling on my fucking For You page. And then I eat my oats.
Same thing every day, and you guys still like them, so I still post them. But when I get these comments, it makes me want to stop. So shut the fuck up. Indica or sativa?
Indica.
Makes you like
just
chill.
Like, relax the fuck out of me. Like,
relax.
You're like, I wanna feel like I'm on a bar again.
Who's the bigger alcoholic?
Like, I don't know.
What's the most psycho thing you have witnessed Tara do?
Are you fucking kidding me right now? Wait, let's like do like a quick like 5 minutes. Maybe that's not psychotic.
Just say whatever you want.
You just like had to pee really badly, so you like literally were sitting down as you were peeing into a bottle.
When I picked him up from the mall, and I was driving on the highway, and I had to pee really bad, so I was driving with my foot on the pedal, with my other foot on the seat, and I was pissing in a cup.
Wait, I'm embarrassed.
And then we passed by a state cop, and I was like, oh my
god.
You're
like, should I stop?
So I sat down really fast, but the cup was really full, so it kind of splattered everywhere.
So, one day I'm just sitting in my bedroom, just getting ready for bed. Tara calls me, I'm like, oh god. Never calls me. I answer the phone. She's like, did Drew text you?
Oh, this
I'm just
story.
Like, yeah. I'm just like, no. She's like, well, can you text him? Because I really need him to answer me. I was like, yeah. So I text him on Snapchat. I'm just like, can you check up on Tara? She doesn't seem like she's doing okay. And he's like, yeah. So he texts Tara, and I later realized that she wanted me to text him because she was waiting outside his house.
Because we broke up, and like he blocked me on everything. He blocked me on everything, so I was like, oh, Jordan can help out. Who gets white girl wasted the fastest? I mean,
who's the white girl?
I mean, me, but like if we were to have a drink off, probably you, because you don't drink as much. We took shots in like a hot parking lot in D.C.
No. Before the meet and greet.
Yeah, we were in Washington, D.C. meeting Ariana Grande, and right before the meet and greet, we took shots of like hot gin out of my backseat in the parking lot.
And then I was literally in the fucking pit. I was like, I need water. I'm going to get blackout.
And they wouldn't give him water. I went up to the fucking guard because we were in the crowd waiting for like sound check, and I was like, hey, my friend is about to pass out. Like, do you have any water?
Sorry, we can't get that out until the show starts.
So I was like, but there's water bottles right there and I can see them.
Literally.
And he's about to pass out, and the guard was like, we can't do it. I'm fucking sorry. I was like, well, he's about to pass out. So, like, what do we do? Briefly describe your first time meeting in real life. Dramatic. Have you guys ever done anything?
If I literally see that question one more fucking time.
Every question is, have we done anything? No. Like, hugged. One time I found one of his dildos in his room. I visited his house once. Usually he comes here, but I went to him once, and, like, I was going through his drawers, and I found his dildo, and I, like, stuck it against the wall, and he was like, "Arrah!" Your biggest fight. What was it?
Why?
How long did it go on?
Questions.
Literally, like, the biggest fight we had, like, it wasn't even a fight, but I remember you were in my bedroom, and I was in the living room at my dad's house. So, like, we sat on opposite sides of the house and, like, didn't talk for, like, an hour. I don't know who made the first move.
It was definitely
But it was kind of just like, hey, we're sitting on, like, opposite sides of the house, like, not talking. We should probably say something.
Oh, it was definitely not me. I didn't make the first. I'm the petty one.
I probably just
will literally ignore her forever.
Yeah.
I would never talk to you again unless you came back to me.
Yeah.
It's the volume inside this bus for me.
It's the volume inside of this bus for us. What's y'all's most traumatic experience together?
Running out of money at Rolling Loud.
Running out of money at Rolling Loud. We went to Rolling Loud with no money.
With $100.
I had to call my mom every five seconds and be like, hey, I need like $5 for a fucking burrito. Like,
can you just can you Venmo me for an Uber?
Yeah.
Can you Venmo me so we can go downtown Miami? Can you Venmo me for Sugar Factory? Can you Venmo me for the fucking deposit on this hotel?
Have you ever been interested in each other? Do y'all get high together? Yeah. Can I tell the story? Yeah, so.
You're not even knowing the story.
So, like, back in the day, when me and him were friends.
Sorry, you're fucking me and him, the fuck out of me.
No, me and him both hated weed. Like, we thought that it was, like, heroin.
No, like our friend used to be, like, literally, like, stoned at the mansion.
Yeah, like, she was still in the mansion all the time, and, like, we thought that she was, like, ruining her life, like, you know, smoking. So, like, we used to make these edits, like, of how she's a junkie.
She was a junkie.
Like, we used to call, yeah. And then I started smoking weed.
And I was pissed.
Only a year went by, and he came over. Yeah, so he was like, maybe I'll smoke. Like, he was, like, hinting to me that he might smoke, so I was getting really excited. And I was. And you smoked with me for the first time.
That was the best high I've ever.
Yeah. Have you guys ever imagined each other doing the deed? Have we ever pictured each other having sex? I've pictured you having sex.
I've definitely seen it.
Have either of you had a girlfriend / boyfriend, and do you want a relationship?
I've had a girlfriend before, and I've had a
boyfriend. You've had a girlfriend before? I didn't know that.
I've had two.
When?
Like a long
Wait, so
time
you
ago.
Still like pretend to be straight? Like
No,
like,
I like, I like.
You like thought you were? Yeah. Wait, how old were you when you had girlfriends?
6th grade.
This is my first time hearing this.
And then 4th grade. And then Howard. We both broke up with me. Like, I don't know. I was just like going along with it.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, love you.
Have you guys ever lied about liking the other person's outfit?
That's fucked. That question is fucked.
I hate it. I saw this earlier. Who's more of an Ariana Grande?
No, I saw that.
Like,
ew, this is so fucking sad.
What?
Have you ever like punched or hit or physically hurt him?
Yeah,
because
he's gay.
Is no one going to talk about the thing in her hand? It looks like a vape. Because it is love. Have you guys ever sent nudes to each other?
I did it like a couple days ago. My ass.
Oh, yeah. I do remember that. You guys want to see me naked all the time, all you creepy men that are still watching this?
Ew!
He's seen them. What was the most cringe moment in our friendship?
Or the way we used to do our makeup. Wait, no, it's the every Friday getting the Kylie lip kits for me.
Yeah.
Mom, we have to stop on the highway. I need to get True Brown K.
Oh my fucking God. It's me paying $130 for True Brown K.
Come get her.
Even your man know Nikki do it better. I know you don't like me. You wanna fight me. Jordan is your only friend, right? So like, every time I post a TikTok about hanging out with people, everyone's like, oh my God, I thought you had no friends. Like, you say that you have no friends all the time and like, you're lying. Like, I'm not lying. Jordan is my only friend. I like, very rarely hang out with like, random people who I used to hang out with.
What's your favorite food?
What's her favorite food? My favorite food's pasta.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Yeah.
An acai bowl.
Oh yeah. Is Jordan ever gonna get his ass done?
I think I need to. I'm gonna do what Tana Mojo did. She just sponsored it at Sculptra. I mean, come on. At 7Q Spa.
All right, so that's the end of this. Thanks everyone for watching. This is Jordan. We're about to have a great couple days together. So I would go on live, but I'm banned because TikTok thinks I'm a scumbag. Now? Bye, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe and like the video to show your to show your support. Turn on the little bell to notify you every time I post a new video. I post every Sunday, and it's always like this awesome content that you guys don't want to fucking miss. But anyways, if you want to follow me on my social medias, I post on TikTok at least 5 times a day, so you should probably follow me on there. That is Tara's World.
Until Trump takes it away from us.
Until Trump takes it away from us. That is Tara's World. My Instagram is also Tara's World. My Snapchat for that, like, crackhead content is Tara143. And my Twitter is All the Love Tara. So follow me on those, because, like, I'm, like, wild and shit. But, like, thank you guys for watching so much.
Bye.
Bye. I love you. And I always get really close at the end of my videos. I need to... It's Jordan's fake Versace shorts for me.
Ah! Don't expose me on fucking Instagram.
But show the real slides. Okay. If you guys ever, like, want to be friends with me, just, like, realize I got these for his birthday. And they're like, oh my god, they're so heavy. These are Versace Medusa slides, and it was my first designer purchase for Jordan, and they're so nice.
Five.
Bye, guys. I love you. Mwah.